Alright, hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder upcoming content video. They just released another dev blog here on the new upcoming United States main battle tank, the M1A2, which is obviously something that I'm sure some of you are going to be very, very excited for. Okay, well, this is... Let me just see here if there's anything I'm missing. Nope. Okay, so let's begin. The M1A2 is among the latest and most capable modifications of the American Abrams MBT, featuring notable improvements in protection as well as other areas. Soon, the highly anticipated M1A2 will also make its way to War Thunder as part of Update 1.93, becoming a new crowning jewel of the American Ground Forces tree. Briefly, the most advanced modification of the Abrams tank in the game, featuring substantial improvements in protection as well as broader selection of ammunition. It is the M1A2. It is a main battle tank for the United States of the 7th rank. Pros are that it has improved protection, more potent and versatile ammunition, thermal imaging view is available for the driver as well as the gunner, and slightly greater ammunition capacity. Cons, however, are that it has slightly decreased mobility due to weight increase, with, like, that's gonna fucking matter on an Abrams, and hull protection borrowed from the previous modification. So we got some screenshots here. We can see it with that very nice looking desert paint, as well as, of course, the also very nice looking iconic tan that you get on these US vehicles. That is one of the only tan paints in the world that I will not puke at. And here we have some history on the unit if you are interested. In War Thunder, the M1A2 will be the new top performer of the American Ground Forces tree following its introduction to the game as part of upcoming Update 1.93. While its outside appearance doesn't stray far from its direct predecessor, the M1A2 nonetheless holds some notable upgrades underneath all that steel plating that very much differentiates it. Fuck that word. That makes it different from the M1A1. For starters, the most notable improvement lies within the M1A2's armor protection. Unlike the M1A1, the M1A2 features composite armor with second-generation depleted uranium components, which substantially bolsters resistance against all ammunition types. In other words, or numbers rather, this improved protection will be most noticeable at the M1A2's turret cheeks, which can absorb around 600mm to 900mm of penetration from kinetic and chemical munition types respectively. However, while this upgrade certainly makes the M1A2 a tougher nut to crack, it also makes it quite a bit heavier and thus negatively impacts its overall mobility as a result. Due to the fact that the M1A2 retains its 1500 horsepower gas turbine engine from previous modifications, while its mass increases to nearly 62 metric tons, the end result is a slightly lower power to rate ratio, which translates into slower acceleration. Despite the weight increase, however, the top speed remains identical to that of the M1A1, 42.25 miles per hour or 68 kilometers an hour. And here we have some nice shots of the vehicle. There it is with the green paint, there's its ass with the tan, and there's the back of its turret with the green. A few further nifty little upgrades to the M1A2 brings with it are several new ammunition types and an independent commander's panoramic sight with thermal vision. As far as the former is concerned, the M1A2 will receive access to the new M8... Fuck. That Discord message scared the shit out of me. This is why I don't play horror games. We'll receive access to the new M830A1 Heat MPT round. Although this shell offers less penetrating power at first glance, it makes up for this by having a proximity-fused warhead, allowing it to be used as a very powerful anti-air round, which will no longer prove its usefulness against airborne threats, such as helicopters in particular at top-tier battles. As already mentioned, among the other improvements made to the Abrams with the A2 version is the addition of the independent commander's panoramic view with thermal vision. This handy little piece of kit will allow commanders of the M1A2 to take full advantage of thermal imaging technology, added to the game with the previous update. Okay, so new MBT for the United States tech tree. It's good to see some more Abrams. I like to see a single series. I've always said this kind of thing. I know not everybody agrees, but I like it when you have a tank that is part of a big ol' series, like a franchise of tanks with multiple variants. I love to see all of those get added and then we just see the collection of that tank type grow. Like, for example, the Sherman. I love to see new Shermans because there are so many different types. I love to see new T-34s, the medium tank, because, again, there are so many different types. Same goes with the German Leopard tank. I'd love to see from the Leopard 1 all the way down now to the Leopard 2A5. I want to see more of those tanks, and now, of course, the Abrams is becoming its own series of tanks in the game, and I would like to see more variants of this. Hopefully, we get some of the other more unique variants of the Abrams at some point, but obviously that's not a priority right now, so they'll focus on things like this, mainline vehicles. Feel free to let me know in the comment section below what you think about the M1A2 coming to the game. I know a lot of people are going to be very happy, and a lot of people are not going to be very happy. But that is what it is at top tier. If you haven't been paying attention to the devlog news, here are some other things that are coming with the next major update. Sweden is going to be coming to the game. Their tech tree will be releasing, their air tech tree will be releasing an update 1.95. So not with 1.93, but you will be able to purchase up to 2 new pre-order packs, premiums for their tech tree, for their aircraft, including the Finnish VL, no, I'm not saying it, which is basically a wooden BF-109, and then also their rank 5 premium J-29D jet. For other aircraft, France is getting the rank 2 693A-B2 attacker aircraft. Helicopters are seeing some new additions. Italy is getting their first helicopter in the form of a premium rank 6A-129. The Russians are getting a rank 6 premium helicopter, the Ka-50 Black Shark. They are also getting a rank 7 gunship, the Mi-28N. For ground forces, the British are getting the Centurion Action 10, which is a rank 4 premium, but they are also receiving the rank 6 Vickers Mark 7 MBT. The Russians are receiving the rank 7 BMP-3 light tank, and the Chinese are receiving the ZTZ-96 main battle tank. Naval Forces is seeing the addition of rank 5 to the tech trees, which will bring with it larger classes of ships, but they are starting with heavy cruisers, of course, bringing with it a new heavy cruiser for the United States tech tree, the USS Pensacola. And that's all of what they've shown on the website so far, but obviously with the dev server that was opened and the live streams they did, there is other content that is coming as well. Still some other new vehicles. They probably won't do a dev blog on many of them, but there is the new British heavy cruiser. There are new premium light cruisers. The Chinese are getting new Japanese premium aircraft in the form of 3 of them. They get an A6M2, I think one of the Ki-45s, and then a Ki-84 that you can get over there. Lots of premium content, but still some stuff kind of thrown in here and there. And of course, the biggest, probably the biggest and most interesting is Sweden is coming, but not until 1.85. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.